Hello, this is Dr. Chris Meletis, and we're going to be talking today about iodine and vitamin D. So I'm looking forward to starting in about a minute. So once again, Dr. Chris Meletis in Portland, Oregon. And you might notice behind me on my little pretty leaf picture, we have sunshine on February 13th here. Pretty amazing. So one of our topics, of course, today will be vitamin D. And so it's apropos that there is some sunlight behind me. And needless to say, I need to get out there and enjoy some of it so I can get my vitamin D levels up as well. We're also going to talk about iodine today. So there's two things that we're going to talk about today which are easy fixes for anyone that can actually dramatically improve fertility, help with miscarriages, and allow us to liberate our overall health and well-being. So of course, this time of year, the cold and flu season, as we enter allergy season, we actually go ahead and start wondering about, well, how do I fortify my body immune-wise? Well, strangely enough, if we had all perfect vitamin D levels, our immune systems would be stronger, our blood pressures generally would be better, our blood sugars could more likely be balanced, because vitamin D is both a hormone and a vitamin. It's one of those interesting substances, which is both a vitamin and a hormone. So we're gonna get started today with talking about vitamin D, and we'll move on to iodine, both of which have been shown to have over a third chance of improving your fertility. Can you imagine just the iodine or just the vitamin D, if they're optimized, can increase your chance of having an improved fertility and increased outcomes of pregnancy. So imagine we've got both of those optimized. So let's share some statistics with you about vitamin D. They did a study of 2,700 women, and they looked at assisted reproductive technology. So these are women that are going beyond the call of duty of what nature normally would require to get pregnant. And they looked at what would happen if their vitamin D levels were improved. So when you correct your vitamin D levels and get them into the optimal range, when I say optimal, I'm not talking about my optimal as a naturopathic physician, but we're talking about the conventional optimal, which is means just in the range. And the range for vitamin D, just so you know, if you were to go and get a blood draw, which I encourage every woman that, and actually man, that is trying to actually help with the conception process, get your vitamin D levels measured. So the range for vitamin D is between 20 to 100. And some of the labs now say 30 to 100. But a lot of the medical literature still goes all the way down to 20, which was changed a while back to 30. 30 is now perceived as the bare minimum a healthy person should have, with rare exception. As a holistic provider, I like to see people around 45 or 50 at the very least, but these studies we're looking at, hey, are a person at 20 or above or below? So let me share some statistics which might be very interesting for you. If you improve your vitamin D levels to an optimal level, you have a 34% chance increased to having a pregnancy. This is powerful. So you're 34% more likely, if you're low in vitamin D and then you improve your vitamin D, to have a pregnancy. That's powerful. They also then looked at, well, you're 34% more likely to have a positive pregnancy test. Well, then you're 46% more likely to have a viable pregnancy. So, hey, I've got a positive pregnancy test, which we know is a good start. Then you're 46% more likely to have a viable pregnancy, one that gets to the point where the doctor says, hey, things are looking good here, this could be it. And then you're one-third more likely to have a full-term pregnancy if your vitamin D levels are optimal. So once again, something very interesting, something very powerful, and something we often forget. And well, why would our vitamin D levels be low? Well, I got sunshine behind me, right? It's February 13th and sunshine's behind me. But the fact is, I spend the vast majority of my time indoors. The other thing is, of course, as you can see my solar panels here, I actually put on sunscreen when I go outside because I don't want to get skin cancer. Well, we were told in the 70s, don't go outside, and my dad's from Greece, so he's an immigrant, and one of the things he taught me is don't salt my food, which we'll talk about today, and don't go outside, you're gonna get skin cancer. So, well, now we wear sunscreen in our makeup, so not me, but makeup, and we wear sunscreen when we go outside, and we're afraid of the sun because of cancer. But then we're not going outside, and we're not getting our vitamin D, and our vitamin D levels have dropped and dropped and dropped as a society. So now I have people in Southern California, Texas, that are patients. I have people over in the Asian countries, which are patients. And their levels are low because we are indoor dwellers. We don't have optimal level. So I tell everybody, get your vitamin D levels measured if you're looking for pregnancy, male or female, because actually vitamin D has been shown for men to help with the nucleus of the sperm, sperm quality, huge. So even for men, and improve their testosterone levels. So we see semen quality, sperm count, as well as the nucleus of the head, which is delivering the DNA to the egg, and so half and half makes a whole. And it also can improve a male's testosterone levels. I've actually gone around the country lecturing to medical doctors on the importance of vitamin D. Now, before we move over to iodine, because I wanted to do it in, out, and very clean today and deliver a lot of content, but I'm also going to put links after this presentation, which actually takes you to the literature, the medical literature, the studies, the ones out of Birmingham, the ones out of Europe, that actually show here is the research, here are where these numbers that I'm speaking as Dr. C here am sharing with you. I'm here to empower, to engage, and to encourage. And so someone says here, I take vitamin D 2000, what dosage should I take? The key here is to get your vitamin D levels measured. I like to see a vitamin D level in the United States. We use a different reference range than Europe and Canada. I like to see it right around 50. Now, the conventional wisdom is, says, hey, well, as long as you hit 26 or 30, you're okay. But I'm going to send you a link. I'm going to put a link after this presentation to the Linus Pauling Institute Vitamin D, which actually shows the blood pressure impact, which is a great thing about pregnancy and preeclampsia and eclampsia. Think of blood sugar, gestational diabetes. Well, vitamin D is going to help you with this as well. But vitamin D, remember, I told you it's a hormone. Vitamin D is a hormone also made from cholesterol. So if you imagine with my fingers here, here is cholesterol. Well, you can make vitamin D. You can make pregnenolone. You can make DHEA. Then you're going to make your sex hormones. You're going to make androstenedione, testosterone, even women, estrogen, even guys, and you're gonna make your progesterone all from cholesterol, but vitamin D is also made from cholesterol, and it's also a hormone. So it's pretty powerful, and it's something that's very encouraging to see. They did another study out of Denmark, and they looked at 1,684 women that were pregnant, and they found that the women that were below 20, remember the range is 20 to 100, sometimes it's 30 to 100, women below 20 had a 2.5 times higher risk of miscarriage if their vitamin D levels are low. Now, isn't that an easy fix? Get your blood levels measured, you're looking to get pregnant, and now 2,000 that someone just asked, that's usually a great start, but I can tell you for me individually, and individual results will vary, it took me at a much higher level 18 months to hit 51. Now, I'm a little heavier, I spend a lot of time indoors, I don't spend enough time doing outdoor activities, but it took me 18 months on a stiff dose to hit my peak level. So measuring to see where you're at, make sure you're in that at least 30, but ideally 50 range, my opinion, talk to your doctor and or a healthcare provider, and then re-measuring and see, have I gotten there? Knowing that it can increase your fertility if you've been low and you get into an acceptable range, it can improve your fertility by over a third. Now, wow, that's an easy fix. Now let's talk about iodine. So iodine's interesting. So much like my dad in 1961, he came to the United States and he learned from television and infomercials and public service announcements, don't go outside, you're gonna get skin cancer. Well, my dad also taught me, don't salt your food, Chris. Salt causes high blood pressure. A lot of it has been told us. A lot of our parents told us this. We've told our kids this. Don't salt your food. Salt is bad. Well, salt's not necessarily bad. It's a sodium-potassium balance. It's when we do things in excess, over-salt our foods. There are a few people which are salt sensitive, and yes, that will dramatically impact their blood pressure. I'm talking about sodium here. But when we invited or disinvited the Morton Salt Girl, if you remember that little blue container and has a little girl with an umbrella that says, when it rains, it pours. Well, my dad said, hey, she's no longer invited to our table, except when we had corn on the cob. And that's a whole nother story. And so go ahead, and Morton Salt was disinvited. Well, where was I getting my iodine? Because it says iodized salt. And because we were not seagoing vegetarians, and we didn't get a whole lot of iodine in our diet. And so it's interesting, vegans have an 80% greater likelihood of being iodine deficient. Vegetarians have over a 30% chance, unless they're seagoing vegetarians, but many of us vegetarianish types, and even our salads, we stop at the seashore. We don't add iodine from seaweed Okay, well, I got my romaine, I got my kale, I've got all these great things. And let me throw some seaweed on top, and now we've got a great salad. Not usually the way it happens. And so iodine levels have dropped. And so they did a study called the NHANE study. It's a national nutritional evaluation that the government does to see what is the state of the union relative to health. And from the 70s, so circa when I was a kid, to the late 80s, early 90s, iodine levels dropped by 50%. So as we got educated, as my dad is an immigrant, learning the English language, got educated, he was said, don't salt your food and don't go outside, Chris. Plus he wanted me to study, that's a whole nother story. And so now I'm not salting my food, my iodine levels are lower, I'm not going outside as much, my vitamin D levels are lower, and therefore that could impact my fertility. Now add the sunscreen and all these other things, then we have another problem. So iodine levels dropped by 50% once again from the 70s to the 80s, thanks to large part public service announcements. Then as a child, I was heavily fluoridated. I had my fluoride toothpaste, my fluoride chewables, and then of course, I had my fluoride rinses in public school. And so fluoride and iodine, they compete. The other thing that competes with iodine is bromide. So let's talk about fluoride. If you're using fluoride toothpaste, this might put you at a higher risk of a relative iodine deficiency. So most of us have low iodine levels or suboptimal iodine levels. If you have a suboptimal iodine level, you have a 46% chance, lower chance of getting pregnant. Okay, well on vitamin D, we were just talking about a 34% chance. Now we have another nutrient, up to 46% lower chance of fertility with just one nutrient. And when I'm doing all these other amazing things to get pregnant, these are very empowering and powerful facts, which I'm going to once again reference at the end of this presentation. And it's like, wow, vitamin D and iodine, what can I do about that? And so they actually found that women that were moderate to severely iodine deficient, when they improved their iodine status, had a remarkable improvement in fertility. But let's talk about vitamin D. Vitamin D helps with hormones, ovulatory hormones. It helps with the blood pressure and the blood sugars, which also, like we've talked in the past with polycystic ovary and higher blood sugars, impact fertility. So vitamin D has all those benefits. Now with iodine, iodine's critical for thyroid function. So if any of you are taking like levothyroxine synthroid, well, that is called T4. And why is it called T4? Because it has four iodines. That's how, why it's called T4. If your body is doing its job right, T4 converts to T3, and this is huge. T3 has, voila, three iodines. So actually you lose one iodine and get T3, you actually have a stronger thyroid in your body. So when I work with my hypothyroid patients looking for pregnancy, I'm measuring TSH, free T4, and free T3. And if you're not familiar with a laboratory called directlabs.com, actually allows you to order your own laboratory testing if your healthcare provider will not do it. Now, always share your laboratory results with your provider, but a lot of healthcare providers these days are not allowed to order certain tests because of new insurance rules and guidelines of not overspending or overtesting. It's a whole new lay of the land for us providers as well. So a lot of my patients will go ahead and measure the vitamin D, the other tests with me that are coverable, and then the other ones are just going to get it done because their health is that important to them. So let's talk about working out. We know that working out, exercising can help with fertility. But do you know that when you sweat, you lose iodine? So most of us are low in iodine, and now we're going ahead and taking it and seeing that if I'm over sweating, I'm gonna become lower in iodine, and I'm gonna need to replace that. Now if I'm fluoridating with toothpaste, or in my zip code 97229, I'm fluoridated in my water, so we don't drink the tap water. We rinse in it, but we don't drink the tap water. But then the other thing is things like Paxil, Prozac, Flovent, they contain fluoride. I'm not saying discontinue those medicines, but they contain fluoride. Well, that's even a more reason for you to talk to your healthcare provider about adding iodine. You wanna also have a prenatal that has vitamin D in it and iodine. Very important, particularly for the female. Now for the male, definitely the vitamin D and some other things. But once again, males, get your vitamin D levels measured. Females, get your vitamin D levels measured. Make sure they're 30 to 50, very important. And so very, very critical because these are game changers. But iodine also helps little baby with its IQ and its brain development. So not only will you have an improved fertility, but when you are now more likely to become pregnant with the iodine, you're actually more likely to also have a child with all things being equal, a higher IQ, and not neurological problems. There's 100,000, now forget political correctness, this is in the medical literature, cretins born per year. 100,000. These are babies that neurologically are not as neurotypical as desired because their iodine levels were not there, their thyroid function wasn't there. Mom's thyroid function often is impacted because mom can't give what she doesn't have. Now, the other thing is in the breast milk, we actually have a large amount of iodine that passes on to baby. That's how important it is for brain development and whatnot. But also, if you're taking a lot of fluoride or fluoride toothpaste or fluoride rinses or fluoride water, that also goes to the baby. And that fluoride water and that fluoride goes to baby, which now can actually lower their IQ, especially if they're low in iodine. Like, oh my gosh. So vitamin D, iodine, we're going to see an improvement in not only fertility, but positive outcomes. So you worked hard, you're getting pregnant, you got there, you've accomplished your goal, and now we want to go ahead and see that this is actually something that we can do easily. We're talking about 34% improvement if you've been low on vitamin D and you get into the optimal, or what they consider optimal, but I still consider suboptimal level of vitamin D, you're gonna actually improve your fertility by up to 34%. If your iodine levels were low and you're in the moderate to severe category, and you correct that, you're gonna actually have a 46% chance, all things being equal. So today's tidbits, today's pearls, vitamin D and iodine are critical. These are things we can easily correct and fix. And next time you're at the seashore, you're like, boy, that little thing that washed up on the shore looks awfully yummy. I wonder if that can improve my fertility. No, I'm not telling you to eat it, but let it be a reminder that not only going to the ocean is therapeutic, but also going out in the sun at the ocean and maybe saying, at the local little cafe, do you have any seaweed dishes? And it actually might just improve your fertility just a little bit. So I wish you all great success. And let me just see if there's any questions here. Whoop, that is my finger, but you probably figured that out. And let's see here. So once again on the dosage, because another question on dosage, just the key is to dose yourself as an individual. So the recommended daily dosage, you're gonna see it at the Linus Pauling Institute. They're suggesting around 2,000, but it depends on how well you absorb. Do you have gluten intolerance? Do you have other absorption issues? How heavy are you? All things being equal, the heavier you are, sometimes the longer it takes to saturate the sponge because vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin. So we kind of want to keep an eye on that. You don't want to go too high. Too much vitamin D is also a bad thing. So once again, test, retest, and like I tell everybody, when you're actually testing yourself, you're no longer guessing. So I'm excited to see how this helps you all in the next months to come. And hopefully we're gonna have some remarkable stories as your vitamin D levels and your iodine levels get to those optimal levels and your fertility as a result gets optimized as well. Well, thank you one and all, and blessings, and enjoy the sunshine as it comes. And remember, get some iodine and talk to your doc. Thanks, bye-bye.